You're actually charging the battery by drifting.
Exactly.
That's the most AMG thing I've ever heard, I think. Hi, and welcome everyone to the latest episode of Inside AMG, where it's going to be all about the future of driving performance. Now, I already had a little chat with our CEO, Philipp Schiemer, and our CTO, Jochen Hermann, on this topic. If you missed out on that video, just click the little icon on top. But today, we're going to dive deep into the technical details that will define our future with two experts. And there we already have the first one. Dennis, hi.
Hi, Felix. Good to see you.
Good to see you too. Now, Jochen already told me a few things about this very special piece of equipment that we got here, our very own high-performance battery. Now, I understood this is not a conventional hybrid battery. What exactly makes this battery so special?
This is completely different. This is something what we developed with our colleagues at HPP in Brixworth. So we tried to set the Formula One technology into a serial car production. And that's something what makes it completely different to every battery you know maybe on the market at the moment. If you take a close look at the cell itself, for example.
This looks like a regular battery that you would use for a flashlight. I mean,
Well, it's not only the battery, but this is one point, one key fact that we developed a different cell. Yeah. This one is especially made for more power. So our target is to have the maximum peak power what we can achieve in such a small battery. So this one is very special. If you combine it with this battery strategy, what we have, and the temperature and the cooling, then it will be completely different. So that makes the difference, actually.
And then you take one of these contraptions here, and then you just stuff a bunch of cells in there.
Exactly. We use 40 cells for each cell frame. And then we use 14 of these cell frames. And then we get 560 cells on the inside of this battery. 560 cells leads us to a voltage of more than 400 volts.
Wow.
And then we get out of this system 150 kilowatt.
150 kilowatts.
Exactly, in peak power.
That is huge in such a small battery pack. I mean, this is still not that big a battery in terms of a hybrid battery. I mean, that's pretty impressive.
Yeah, that was another target of us. To get the high power density, we are not only focused on the power, we also need to reduce the weight as much as possible. Mm-hmm. As you can see, this housing here is a housing made of thin walls of sand casting. Mm-hmm. And this helps us to reduce the weight to 89 kilograms.
What do we have here? I mean, there's a lot going on in this part as well.
This is actually the brain of the system. This is the intelligence. This is where the battery management system is. So this is where we measure everything, where we see what is the voltage of the system, what is the current what we have and put through the system. This is where we measure actually everything. Mm-hmm. But also it's a compartment for the cooling.
So there is some sort of cooling liquid in there, or how do you do that?
Exactly. This is a non-conductive liquid cooling. So this chamber right here where the cells are is completely flooded with special fluid. And with this one, we can cool down the battery and set the temperature at the right spot where we need to have it.
That's crazy. I never heard anybody do that before.
Even in a serial production, we have never seen something like this before.
And with this internal cooling mechanism, you always operate within the perfect temperature range.
Exactly. What we said is 45 degrees is the perfect temperature of each cell in our system, and therefore we try to keep every single cell at that temperature. On a standard battery, that's completely different. This is something what I can show you on the video screen right here.
Okay.
So if you consider a standard battery, actually, if the cells meet the 60 degrees, every other battery will stop, actually. They will go down with the power to save the structure, save the cells, save everything of the system, and then you lose your power. Mm-hmm. But that's nothing what we want to do. What we want to do is completely different.
That's
what I said, but that's something you will just get with the direct cool system.
Yeah, you can take in power, take out power, and you're always within the perfect temperature range.
Exactly. What we have, what I didn't show you on the battery, is the heat exchanger. This part, which is divided red and blue, this is our heat exchanger where we get the heat out of the system actually and transfer it to the vehicle system. Mm-hmm. And then that helps us that we keep the battery temperature at this 45 degrees. And like you said, we can use the battery not only for taking the power out, but also to put the power in. And that's all the time. It's always on.
That's why you use the F1 analogy. This is basically motorsports technology, exactly what you would want on the racetrack. Always have the power when you need it.
Exactly. That's the big point, what we want to have with this battery. And the strategy, how that works, that's something what Jochen can maybe tell us, and he will help you with the strategy of the system.
Wonderful. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Jochen, hi. Nice to see you. How's it going?
Fine, thanks.
We got some pretty nice equipment here. I've already learned that hardware-wise we're in tip-top shape, but I've already learned that it requires a specific operational strategy to get everything going. What is that exactly?
If you consider it, the internal combustion engine the heart of the AMG, the operation strategy will be the brain of the whole powertrain system.
And the driver still has control by using different settings, I suppose, of the system, right?
Right. You already know from our conventional models, there are some drive programs like C, S, S+. In this system, we're able to drive fully electric. And we wanna give the customer the opportunity to drive in complete silent mode. If you're starting in the morning and you don't wanna disturb anybody or wake up, so you can go fully electric.
So we got the new bespoke electric drive program for electric driving, and then you move onwards through the drive modes, comfort, sport, sport plus, and so on. How does the operational strategy change through those modes?
We'll talk about first the C mode, our most efficient mode, and therefore the most high sophisticated mode as well, because this is the only mode where the operation strategy automatically will change from pure electric driving to combined driving and to boost mode.
So this all happens automatically in the background, in the comfort mode. The driver doesn't have to do anything. The system selects for itself the most efficient mode to move forward.
You're just driving, and the system in the background always will use the most efficient way to get you from A to B.
That's very handy. And then, of course, you move onward to more sporty driving, which is, of course, where it gets interesting for us.
For performance hybrid, of course, the sporty ones are the most important for many of our customers. So we focused on that a lot. When you move up from C to S or even higher, the ICE will never stop. So it will continuously be able to provide you the whole system power from the electric side and from the combustion side.
So that's the always on strategy. We always have the internal combustion engine on and the whole system activated.
Exactly. So this is the other part of always on. The one is the part where you never lose power on the electric system. And the other one is you don't want to stop the ICE. Because if you always have the combination of electric motor and the combustion components, you are all set for getting drive off.
And then you get into that groove of always getting power in and out of the battery with each move you make with your feet on the pedals, basically, right?
Exactly. And then we're coming to a special feature. We're putting in this P3 powertrain first, the selectable recovery system. So you're able to select the level of recovery you want to get from your electrical system. And therefore, we're able to provide from sailing till one pedal drive for the customer a wide range of possibility how we use the acceleration pedal or the brake pedal. So perhaps you know from PHEV cars, if you lift your foot from the acceleration pedal, there will be a massive drag that charges the battery, of course, but will slow you down. And if you want this feeling and you like it, you can have this with a P3 e-performance version as well.
I have to say, both ends of this spectrum are very interesting to drive. The one pedal drive you mentioned, but also the sailing side of things, you lift your foot off the pedal and you just sail on like nothing happens. And you can experience both ends of the spectrum with the P3 hybrid concept. So is there any specific thing that changes when you then move onward from Sport Plus to, say, Race, to the sharpest program we got?
And this we defined very closely together with our colleagues from the racetrack. So the race drivers especially designed with us the features of the e-performance system on the race driving mode.
Awesome. So this is real motorsports know-how that went into that drive mode, straight from the racetrack through our racing drivers.
Exactly. And there are two main goals we want to achieve. The one is preciseness. Mm-hmm. So if you're driving round corners, you have to brake. You need to be precise. So we want to reduce the drag torque we already spoke about. And we only give the driver the full control of the recuperative and the friction braking system on the brake pedal. So there will be no drag torque, first. Second, when you go out the corner, you want to have precisely always the same power and the linearity of your acceleration pedal, allowing you perfectly drive off every corner and accelerate in the optimum way.
I mean, that's completely logical. Yeah, it would be probably very irritating for a race driver to take his foot off the accelerator and then the car immediately slows you down without you touching the brake. But that you achieve this continuous force of recuperative braking and regular braking just throughout the whole way of the braking pedal, that is revolutionary.
You will not get any hint where the recuperative braking is ending and the friction braking is taking over, because we're starting with friction braking on a very, very low level, so we're not losing energy and keeping efficiency of the recuperative system very high. And then when we're coming to the point where the battery or the e-system is limiting us, so we're handing over to the friction, is all one controlled strategy in one brake system. So this will not hand over from one to one and there will be some lag or anything, but it will just go the all way from zero to hero.
That is amazing stuff. So you always put power back into the battery. No matter what you do, some way it finds its way back into the system.
Exactly. We will not waste energy, because efficiency and recuperation is also the main strategy to faster lap times.
Pretty cool. Are there any other ways you can get more power into the system, back into the system, and not waste it?
One Easter egg out of the software development. If you're perhaps drifting, you also being able to recuperate. So we use the electric system to slow down or take the load out of the ice, putting it in the battery, and then if the slippery condition is over, the ice is already on full load and you can accelerate much, much faster. And while drifting, you were able to recharge the battery.
So you're telling me not only does the IC not cut down the power, but you're actually charging the battery by drifting.
Exactly.
That's the most AMG thing I've ever heard, I think. That is absolutely crazy. Thank you very much for these very interesting insights. I've learned that if we do a hybrid, we do it the AMG way, definitely. That was very, very interesting. Thank you very much for that.
You're welcome.
So if you guys liked what you've seen today, don't forget to drop us a like. Also subscribe to the channel so you don't miss a video whenever we upload new content. Today we've learned a lot about the future of driving performance, so there are definitely a lot of interesting new products right around the corner. Stay tuned for that. Also stay tuned for more videos. Comment down below what you would like us to shoot next. So until the next one, bye-bye.